You gotta add the leafy base, then add everything else on top. I see you, I see you. Man. I gotta learn, so you guys remember, I know they went bankrupt because I used to work for a company that used to sell stuff to them. But there used to be a buffet called Soup Plantation. And they would sell nothing but soup and salad and bread. And that was basically the draw, and it's a buffet. And I actually liked going there because they actually had some pretty good salads. They actually went bankrupt a couple years before COVID started. And yeah. They're no longer a thing, but they used to have a really good Asian chicken salad that I really want to learn to make now. Because if I want to make a salad as like a midstream snack or something like that, I feel like I want to do something like that. It was a salad, it was light, there was chicken for the protein. Sweet tomatoes is exactly Soup Plantation. They're the same company, if you didn't know. And it's kind of like Carl's Jr. is the West Coast name. And then on the East Coast, they're called Hardee's. It's the same exact dynamic. On the different regions, they just have a different name. Although everything they sell is identical. So sweet potatoes and Soup Plantation went bankrupt. And I believe it just ended up being something along the lines of there's too much debt. And then they got bought out by another company. So I think the other company took their locations to expand their own restaurants while, you know, taking over the debt, but getting the machinery and equipment. So that's why a lot of them closed down. I think there's only like three of them that exist in the US now, Ace Cow. There's a lot of, I don't know what happened there, but I just know that things happened there. That guy's too old. That guy's 8. I'm taking him. 68. He's almost 69. Oh, both of these guys need to get wrangled. 93. That's too old. I'll take the 53 guy. And I'll also take the 68 guy. And then this guy is 95. He's too old. All right. We'll wrangle as many of them as we can. If we have any leftovers, we'll be okay. Sweep that. Take this, copy, paste. I liked it though, Ace Cow, because it's like, I'm going to eat an all-you-could-eat buffet. But I don't feel bad about it because it's salad. It was the guilt-free all-you-could-eat, man. It really was. Time to go home. Dude, look at the star map, dude. We got so much uncovered today. I love going to salad and bread. Yeah, man. I would get the chili that they had there, add onions and cheese, and then get the focaccia bread that they had. And I would eat that as kind of like my main dish. I was always open up with two plates of salad. A full plate of Caesar, a full plate of their Asian chicken salad. And then I'd have some of the soup afterwards. It was just good, man. I don't know how else to describe it. Stuff was delicious. It really was. Alright, so I have water dripping. What's going on? Oh, pipe keeps melting. That's right. I just kind of need to run this then. Huh? I don't want to burn away my uranium. Oh, damn. Y'all see this? Look at how hot my Radbolt generator's on. I forgot to turn this on. Release a little bit of oxygen. And watch the temperature, the Radbolt generators just plummet. Gotta have the cooling system, boys. Alright, so this is a rad bolt for the Drocone. I don't have diamond. Maybe I should wreck this and do another rocket to explore. We'll have to explore that side and then this side. So in terms of terrestrial artifacts, this one doesn't have any, right? I haven't explored it fully. There might be, you know, artifact right there, but I'm not 100% sure. This also has the forest core, so we could have an artifact at the bottom. I should actually go check. Yeah. Okay, so that means I need someone with digging skill. And that's going to be Cthulhu. All right, Cthulhu, you're going to be a scout today. If you're not going to get databank, so we're going to send you over to the other side and have you explore. What time do you wake up? Oh, you're just going to sleep? Perfect. Good times. What's going on unnoticed? How are you? That's Pog indeed. We're going to break 4 digits, man. Now, we'll probably beat the game before that happens. I hate to say that. And gotta wait for Cthulhu to wake up. I can't get past day 100. Hey, if you didn't know, unnoticed. I have a YouTube channel, and I have a lot of tutorial and guide videos on there. If you're running into some specific issues, maybe I have a video that already helps you out. You can also watch my VODs from how I play from the beginning to end. And if you have any specific problems you would ask me live, dude, ask away. I'd be happy to help. So let me know what kind of issues you're running into. I'll try to help you out. But, dude, I have over 200 videos covering over Oni topics from VODs, from tutorials and guides, going over things like certain build designs, things like how pips work, how to make a steam turbine aqua tuner setup, the proper piping loop for that. So, yeah, ask away. Or check out the YouTubes when you have time. Alright, so Cthulhu should be awake now, right? We're sending him to the gulag. Come on, Cthulhu, it's time. Oh, I need a deodorizer right here. I'll put one here and here. Come on, Cthulhu. I see you with your hat. All right. So we're looking for a artifact. Nothing else here really matters. Whoa, where are you going? You're going to generate power. We don't need that. All right, so you're not going to do that because we don't need to send anything back right now. Next thing you're doing is storing materials. This is here? No. Oh, it's the oil. He doesn't need that anymore. Now he's idle. Nice. So with that, we want him to go across the biome. It's probably faster to go down this way and then go down that way. Yeah, honestly, I think that's the case. So I probably do this. I want to go straight down, so we're going to build a ladder well. And then we'll get to here, and we'll be able to climb down to the kitchen. See what we have in store at the bottom. Cthulhu working, I see you, man. Thank you. Usually cooling in O2, I usually only play 5v5 comp games and shooters, so just getting into these kinds of games. Oh, okay. I see you over there, unnoticed. So when it comes to cooling, I'm assuming that you only have early game options because you're saying that you can't get past day 100. So the first thing I would recommend, actually, you know what, before I ask that, are you playing with the DLC or are you playing just the base game? That's going to be a good question because your options are going to depend on which one you have. You have just base game. Okay. So on the base game, one of the big differences is your map is going to be about 3 times larger than my map. I'm playing with the DLC and they shrink the maps. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to look for these things right here. If you can. This setup right here with the black tiles called Neutronium right here. you're going to be looking for these. These buildings underneath are random geysers or vents. So if you go to the database up top and you go into the geysers, all of these geysers right here, you're going to get one of them underneath this. And one of the options you can run into is a cold water geyser. So a cold polluted water at minus 10 or a cold salt geyser at minus 10. Either way, you're looking for cold water. And if that's not good enough, your only other option is something along the lines of a 30 degree polluted water setup. Even then, 30 degrees is not that much. So if you do have the cold water geyser, and that means you need to be exploring a lot of your areas because you're looking for these chunks, and what you could do is go to your priority tab right here, click on this, click on the exclamation point, and then highlight this with the number enclosed inside. And then you're going to see the exclamation points on that. Escape, click on the yellow alert on the top left, and it's going to tell you exactly what type of geyser you have underneath. So this is a minor volcano. You can click on this to see more details about that, but that's the geyser I have underneath. So you could use that technique to find your geysers and try to find a water source. Because if you have a water source, you could do some really good cooling with that. Now, if you can find a cold water source, you could skip a lot of the in-between progression stuff and steps that you would need to take. Because if you have cold water, you could do something called a cold water loop. Because the water starts at minus 10, you could start off by piping out the water and then having that transport in insulated pipelines like this, and run it in a loop, right? So it would be something like this. You would run the polluted water that's really cold. You can see right here, it's minus 8. Run it in a loop and have a temperature check set up right here. So my temperature check is the moment that the temperature of the water running over the pipes is above 20 degrees, we release the water and we have colder water come back in. That way I could maintain temperature. Because what you guys don't see in this room setup is that my polluted dirt right here is 70 degrees Celsius. But I'm fighting the heat by running a cold loop around it. That polluted dirt comes from my ethanol distillery right here, where it starts off at 90 degrees. So I'm using the cold water to maintain and equalize the temperature around my hot area. That's exactly what you would do otherwise. But if you have a cold water source, you could have a simpler setup like this. The proper setup, if you didn't have a cold water loop, would be doing something like this. You could run a steam turbine on top of an aqua tuner. The aqua tuner forcefully lowers the temperature of your cooling liquid by 14 degrees Celsius. And what I am doing with this is I'm chilling this box. And you could see that I'm insulating the box with insulated tile so that the cold energy doesn't leak out, making it a lot easier for me to maintain the temperature. So I wanted to grow this plant, the sleet wheat, and the only temperature range that it's available to grow in is minus 55 Celsius to positive 5 Celsius. So these are typically the plants that grow in the ice areas. Now, no, Twitch is forcing an ad. Let me know when you're back, man. Diligent, welcome on in. Wow indeed. If you have any questions, man, feel free to ask. I feel like I can't pronounce your name, dude. I'm very sorry. Help me out with that, please. I see Diligent, Fat Quad, this. I don't know, man. There's a lot of words in there I can't read. Huge advice. Yeah, man. I got the best advice in the business. Let me know what kind of help you need, and I got you. You could also dig it out all to a certain tile and it won't activate. That's true too. Second tile from the left. Yes, that's going to be this tile. If you leave that tile there, it can't erupt. So from the bottom left of the neutronium, you go over 1 and up 2. And that's going to be the tile. Yeah, man, they're trying to keep up with YouTube and the ad game. But, you know, they're never going to catch up with YouTube, sadly. Cthulhu can't reach the foods. Oh, you're hungry, buddy? Let me help you out. By having you continue digging. No soup for you today. Is there zombie spores here? No. Okay, that's good. Never mind, it's Korean. Oh no. I don't know Korean. I know you say Anyo or something like that to say hi, but I'm probably not saying it right. I learned a little bit and I forgot it all in college. They don't think it be like it is, but it do. I learned in college to impress some Korean girls because they were super cute. And then I forgot it all the moment I left college. Don't you hate it when that happens, man? You learn something and you forget. Forever starving. No, man, you're fasting. It's part of the diet plan. It's part of the diet plan, man. No worries. All right, we'll go down this way. I don't think we're gonna have an artifact, but we might. I want to get to the bottom. If Cthulhu starts starving, he has a lot of calories, we'll have him go home. All right, so by running the cooling loop like this, we're running a cold liquid that's at minus 17. And the aqua tuner building is how you would otherwise chill any of your liquids to a very low temperature. So you're able to do the same type of cooling loop that we established here. So the cooling loop is kind of what you're looking for if you're looking for cooling. If you don't need extreme cooling like the cooling loop, because this is a very easily overpowered setup, and it might be a little bit too much for what you need to do, there's a lot of things to do for spot cooling. Spot cooling is typically a unique method that's very temporary, and you could do things like this. Let me give you an example. So you could see that in this area, it's a little bit warm, and you know it's in the it's approaching hot, and a lot of the times you don't want that. And depending on the area, you might want to cool it down, keep it cool, or whatever it may be. So let me build a couple things here. I'm gonna put a tile here, and one thing you could do is if you have ice, that's another thing you could use to cool down the area. However, anytime you have ice and you're utilizing it to cool down an area, it's temporary at best. However, let me actually do a different area. This is probably the best one. However, it's actually really good spot cooling. Spot cooling is cooling an area for that exact instant and then hoping that it doesn't climb back up too fast. So that's spot cooling. A lot of the times, the best method for that is getting the temp shift plate building into the utilities tab and using ice as the material. If you have that, we'll show you the powers of this. So I'm gonna put it at the bottom. Normally, you're gonna want this touching the sides of the walls or the floor. And we'll show you why in a second. Only vanilla ice, right, dude? Have you ever had shaved ice cream, Tristan? Shaved ice cream, I feel like it's something people don't really know about. All right, so once you build the ice temp shift plate like this, look at the temperature. Look at the temperature, look at the template, right? Look at the color change. Bam, it immediately chills down the tiles and then it releases the ice that melts into water in the area and it continues to cool it down. It immediately chills it. This is a very good strategy for spot cooling areas that are getting too hot and it's affecting your plants from growing. So if you don't have a box to grow plants like I do and you have it out in the open, this is going to be a very good method. If the temperature from, let's say, like your water sieve, it's getting warm and it's warming it up so much that you can't grow mealwood anymore, you could actually just use your ice and you could find it in the ice biome and use that, build a temp shift plate, immediately chill it out, and then it'll stop trying to warm it up. You could also use this on top of the mealwood area. Make sure you don't overcool it though, because you might get on the lower side of the threshold of the range, so that might hurt you. But what you want to do is something like this. You want to put tiles on the side so that you could hold on to the cold water. The cold water is still cooling down the area. As you can see, it's still single digit temperatures. So it's going to start cooling down all the tiles until it gets to a aggregate, you know, convergent point. So this is going to warm up. This is going to cool down. Once it evens out, it's going to, you know, basically you just mop it up and use it for research or something. But that's only feasible with ice, to be honest, because the temp shift plates require a solid. Now, I don't know if you could use solid ethanol for that, Matigo, if that's the question. But a lot of the times, you want to use ice specifically because of the stats. Water, if you guys didn't know, regular water is top three in terms of specific heat capacity. And because it's top three, you want to use this more often than not because it's the best coolant liquid until you get to the higher tier liquids. Now, the only thing you're worried about is the freezing point and evaporation point, which you have 100 degrees to work with. But the reason why this is good is because specific heat capacity is, for lack of better words, how much thermal energy they need to be affected by before they actually change temperature. So because you have a high value here at 4.179, a lot of the things are closer to 0 or 1. You would have to influence the water temperature by 2 to 3 times more thermal energy than anything else around it, typically. Unless it's, you know, other liquids, but any other gas like oxygen, if you look at the stats, it's only a 1.05. So in layman terms, you would need 4 times the thermal energy to heat up water than you do to heat up oxygen, with everything being the same in terms of mass. So 160 kilograms of water and 160 kilograms of oxygen. It's going to be a lot faster to heat up or cool down the oxygen than it is to heat up or cool down the water. 4 times. So you could say that it's going to take 4 times longer if it's going to be consistent heat energy that's coming out. So because of that, you want to try to use ice and water anytime you can. And that's going to be the reason why it's the best. Now, although if you do have other items that are able to build into the temp shift plate, or you have it already as cold and you want to use that to build, you could try. But the temp shift plate isn't actively something that cools down an area. The temp shift plate averages out the temperature. So the best way to describe it is, in my steam turbine room, I have temp shift plates made out of sandstone. What the temp shift plates do is they even out the temperature of the inside of the building. So that even though all of my heat generation is at the top, the entire room is even in temperature. It's 118 at the top, 118 at the bottom. And that's because I'm running temp shift plates to even out the thermal energy. So that's the properties of that. When you build one of these out of ice, what you're trying to do is melt the ice, because ice has worse stats than water does. So if I go into ice, the stats for this is a 2.05. So theoretically, what you want to do is melt the ice so that you get the water stats. And since water is going to be double that at 4.179, it's going to be the most attractive thing that you have most of the time. So that's going to be one method. The other thing you could do for cooling, if you want slow but consistent cooling, is you'll probably run into this, an ice biome. Ice biomes typically have wolframite, ice, snow, salt, maybe polluted ice, right? Maybe brine ice, depending on the area you're at. And what you're going to be looking for is this building. This plant is called the Weezewort. And what you could do is build one of these, because this is a slow cooling mechanism. So to give you an idea, I built 2 of them right here. And you could see that this little bubble around the Weezewort, it's colder than everything else around it. That's because the building in and of itself is cooling down the area around it. So you could actually put a couple of these around some of your heat generators, as long as the temperature does not go above 95 degrees, and you could have it slowly cool down the area. So this is a good method as well, if you can find these. And these are typically very important, because you're not given a lot of these plants, and you can't grow them, so you can't grow to have more of these. You have to find them in the wild, or you get them from your printing pot. So if you do have the Weezewort, I would highly recommend getting these, building the planter boxes, and then using them to spot cool. I'm also doing it in this area. So I'm building ethanol, and it's around 90 degrees. Because I didn't want the polluted dirt to get too hot, I have some Weezewort in here, trying to slowly cool it down. so that it doesn't generate heat indefinitely, get above 100 degrees, start breaking some of the buildings. So that's how I'm maintaining the temperature balance, by putting a wheeze wart in the hot area. You could also do things like putting a wheeze wart in, like right here. You could see that my area right here was getting warm. And you actually, you can't tell anymore. But since I put the wheeze wart there, it's chilling down the area around it pretty consistently. So that's another method that I would recommend, that's really easy to set up for if you're running into cooling issues. Hope that helps. And of course, people else, if you guys have some other questions in chat, feel free to ask. I'll be happy to help you guys out. But yeah, I am a plethora of knowledge. There's also the YouTubes, you guys, exclamation point YouTube. If you guys want to check out some of the videos, I've gone over a lot of topics already, a lot of designs, concepts. So if you guys want to check that out, it'll help me out too. If you guys watch the videos, watch the ads, don't forget to like and subscribe, you guys, you know what to do. But yeah, I got you guys if you guys need it. All right, this is 0.6, 1.2. That's not bad. Speed that up. Maddie Go, how are you? Hope you're doing well. Hope I answered your question as well. I have, it's amazing. Dude, so when I say shaved ice cream, I'm not talking about shaved ice though, trust it. So do you know, so can you describe the shaved ice cream? Because the one I'm talking about, it's very, like, it's hard to look up. Because if you Google it, you get results for other types of ice cream. Instead of getting shaved ice cream, you get shaved ice, you know, things like that. But could you describe that, man? Could you describe that? The Korean ice cream, right? I don't know if it's Korean. I don't know if it's Korean, actually. So I'll describe it. The shaved ice cream is usually a specialty item. So you would have to have a store dedicated to shaved ice cream, and it wouldn't be an add-on at like a regular cafe or anything. What a shaved ice cream is they take ice cream, it's a full block of it, and they shave it into thin, paper-thin slices. And they tend to curl up. And they shave it top-down. So it's actually shaved like you're skinning a cucumber. Like it's really thin. And because it's so thin, when you actually eat that, it immediately just melts in your mouth. And it's amazing, dude. It's amazing. Yeah, okay. So you guys have had that. Wait, so it's Korean? I didn't know that. I didn't know it was Korean. As a boogie beans, I have no idea what that is. I guess, yeah, maybe it has Korean roots. The place I went to, all they did was serve us ice cream. They would ask for things like, you want condensed milk? And then, you know, whipped cream, stuff like that. But yeah, I don't know culturally who it belongs to. I just know that I've had it before. All right, Cthulhu's dying. We got to save him. Cthulhu, where you at, man? I heard you're hungry, so we gotta get you a sandwich. Come on, Cthulhu. Aw, you're taking a dump? Get out, dude. Try to send you home. He's taking a dump. We got bathrooms at home, man. I thought it was a Turkish thing. The hard part is trying to preserve it while preventing it from melting. Yeah, it's tough. I feel like that's 100% like a winter dish that you can enjoy during wintertime because it's not gonna melt in the cold. Oh, you don't know where it's from, but it's in Koreatown. Oh, you just take two dumps? What's wrong with you, dude? This guy got the mad bowel movement. That's his second dump today. And it was back to back. Come on, man. It's time to go home. It's time to go home, Cthulhu. No food, two dumps? I don't know, man. You gotta ask Cthulhu. He's been eating too much of the quesadillas and the, you know, chicken dip. So guys, if you guys didn't know, I made Cthulhu gain 30 pounds because I told him that. So he told me that he got a... chicken dip or something like that, where they'll give you the meat and then they'll give you the cheese and you add milk and you heat it up and you get your own, like, kind of like a Kessel dip. And it's like a Kessel kit, right? So he would buy that from time to time. And a biscuit queso. There we go. So he would get that from time to time, right? He would just get the biscuit, brisket. And, you know, get the cheese melted with the milk and you get some really good dipping sauce. So, biscuit. Yo, my bad, dude. My bad. It's the accent, man. It's the accent. So what happened was that I was like, dude, couldn't you just take that and put it all on a large tortilla? And that's a quesadilla. And he's like, holy shit, that's right. So that week he bought 5 Kessel kits and he ate it 5 times. And then from that was a couple months ago. I heard from Cthulhu he gained like 30 pounds. Kappa. I don't know if he actually gained 30 pounds. It just sound good for the story. But yeah, man. They don't think it be like it is, but it do. Sometimes it's all about the biscuits, man. The biscuits and gravy. Who's starving? Come on, Cthulhu, you gotta stop starving, man. What are inside the rocket housing modules? Rooms. These are private bedrooms for the people. They have their own private bathroom set up. You know how it is. Gotta have the statue inside the bathroom. They sleep on the nice bed with the carpeting. And then we have some algae terrariums and oxyferns to make sure that they have oxygen inside. It's a master shake, man. We have the private bedrooms. Yo, man, don't talk about the oxygen, Dr. Duckling. No one's stressed. That's a lie, dude. No one has popped eardrums. Shit, dude. 8.2? Yeah, they're getting popped eardrums up the yin-yang, man. It's a bad time. But no one is stressed. Everybody's happy. Everybody's happy, man. Oh, God. Alright, so I am gonna make the Nature Reserve Shower Combo. That's fancy. Yeah, you gotta be fancy sometimes, man. You gotta be fancy. Alright, so we're gonna redo the piping here, and that's fair. We're gonna do it like this. And then I'll do it like that. And then once we're ready, we're gonna change the pipeline from here to there. Too fancy? No, it's not. Hey, Ace Cow, didn't you want a mug? Didn't you want a mug? Oh, Geek wanted a mug. I'm sorry. Geek gets his mug. Geek wanted the office mug. I got him. Wait, did I miss? Oh, it's not actually... You didn't do the artifact thing yet. It's only those two. Feels bad. Oh, they're back? Okay. Guess what, boys? We gotta turn on the, cooling is a little bit better. I need to cool up the top. Plasma lamp, we got a plasma lamp. You want that, Ace Cow? You want the lava lamp in your room, dude? It actually has light, so you get a night light, dude. Wouldn't it be bad. We gotta charge our Radbolt engines right now, though. Let's do it, alright, Ace Cow. Where is your root? You got the second one, right? Mr. Arrow Capital Fellow. Ace Cow! Alright, we'll give you the plasma lamp. Not bad, not bad. No space colonies complete without one. We got you. Alright, so now that's in. We're going to make our shower nature reserve combo so that everyone always gets 9 morale every day so that we don't have to worry about stress from Cthulhu. They don't think it'd be like it is, but it do. Alright, so let's set it up. We'll do... one shower, and then it's one shower. Wait. So one shower, we have a plant. And then how many plants do I need? 4? Four wild plants, okay. You make it sound like I'm causing stress? I'm literally saving lives. No, you're too stressed from saving the lives. That's what it be, man. That's what it be. 1, 2. We'll have that. So, 1, 2. those should be my four. And then one. So how much is this? This is 14. So I get 7 showers in between. The last thing I need is a park sign. So that's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So we do one more. Oh, that doesn't matter. Oh, this is not even though. Feels bad. Oh, this is... Oh, no, that's because I built the tiles. Alright, we're going to have a weird setup then. No. I'm actually going to move everything over. I think that's actually what I need to do. So we're going to make this smaller so that I actually get a middle point. That's so petty. All this work, you could just use natural tiles mod. What's mods? I see you over there, Ace Cal. Natural tile mods, the memes. I see you over there. Alright, so now that that's there, I want to run this through so that I could have the pipes already inside of the tiles. I'm going to want to cut that, and we're going to have this go this side, and then we're going to go to the bridge and deconstruct it. Master Shake, hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a good Tuesdays, man. So I could trim that now, destroy the rest. Not bad. Buildable dirt tiles is the best. I see you guys over there coming in with your memes and your mods. I see you guys, man. All right, so plumbing wise, so I would be here. So I would be here. Here, here, here. And then we get the park sign in the middle. Hey, there we go. And then the last thing I need is a critter drop-off and some plants. So a storage bin for the seeds. Not bad, not bad. Oh, new printables. Very sorry. I will grab sandstone because I'm feeding that to my hatches. Still charging. We don't have enough uranium. Let's go for another cycle. And it looks like the top Radbolt generator needs a little bit more oxygen. I could try to make another one up top, but I can't build ladders going up anymore. Feels bad, man. Too tight of a build. As long as this doesn't get too hot. Releasing a lot of oxygen, but I don't mind it. Technically, I could just build a tile here to help out. We just need the oxygen to go to this tile. A little bit more quantity ones to cool it down. Oh yeah, we gotta release this. Oh, we got the radiation mood ring. The office mug, geek wanted that. And then we have the second office mug. Oh, feels bad, man. Is that a duplicate? Ah, I didn't want to get two. I did not want to get two of those. Be like that though sometimes, I suppose. Alright, so this is... pipes are ready. Alright, this is going to be a priority 9 pip. This is going to be 5 Joya seeds. Joya, Joya, Joya. Right there. Okay, so that's fine. Deconstruct only buildings. And then we're gonna need ladders here, here, here. And then we're gonna need a pip. So this guy's chilling. We gotta turn this off. And then we're gonna move one of these guys. 57. Well, how old's the other guy? 33. Yeah, we'll take this guy. We'll take this guy. Dude, that's a lot of polluted oxygen, man. I'm impressed. I really am. Look at them dancing, drinking soda. Dancing, drinking soda. I see the guys over there. Oh, they're not pulling the pee water? Where'd they grab that from? 200 kilograms? Where did this bottle of pee water come from? That's a lot. That's actually a lot. That's kind of impressive. Alright, so they took out the joyous seeds. Alright, we need... Nope, just planning. Let's go. We got that right there. We could remove the critter drop-off. We could remove the bin, because we have enough seeds. Yep. And then... We want to have a lot of bathrooms. I mean, showers. We got to make sure there's always room for people to shower. Alright, so now that that goes that way, we connect that. We could connect this. And this has to be a dirty water line. Okay. I would have to go, like, behind right here, which shouldn't be too bad. So, it's already a clean water line here. Oh, I could do that here. Haha. And then this is going to be the dirty water line. That makes sense, because it's just going to be like that. Okay. Because it's probably cleaner to have it go behind the pitcher or pixel packs. Or no, we'll just have it through the door like that. Yeah. So, what I would do is this. Cut that. And then we would connect that. That and that. Yeah, and then I empty out the pipe first. Yeah. And then we cut this here, so that's going to be the end of that pipe, and then we could remove this. Now that that leaves, we need to get the extra water bubble. We need to get that out. So we need someone to drink water. Oh no, I could actually just, okay, this is ready. So here. I could actually just put it into the showers, right? Kind of like that. And then that would be at least one bubble of water out of the pipeline. And then that should empty that out. Long stream tonight, almost home from work. Hey, dude, man, Miss Arrow Capital Fellow. Always working, dude. This guy works hard. And it feels bad, man. I don't get to see him anymore. Appreciate you though, Mr. Errol Capital Fellow. You were actually our most stressed out dupe today. And we had to actually reset your dupe. Oh, the kitty cat's awake. Look at him looking to the camera. Kitty cats. He's like, is it time? And he's awake. Nice. This should be perfect. Now we have the last tile to go for. And we just need the Mr. Pip. Take care of business. Take care of business. I hear you, Mamba. You're doing all right. The Mamba wants my attention. Don't worry though, I'll still be streaming you guys. All right, this works because this is a germy water, and then showering in that's fine. What? How? Did he run Crisis? How did he do that? How did he burn his video card? What was he playing? Dude. What the hell? All I gotta say is, that's gonna be expensive, man. That's gonna be expensive. Feels bad, Ghost Rider, man. Feels bad. You hate to see that kind of thing happen, boys. You really do? Kid burns up his graphics card? Oh, man. That's a bad time. And nice, we got the nature reserve. So we're gonna get the 6 morale bonus every time we step inside. And then showering gives us 3 morale. So this is good times all around. All right, all right. So I don't have to worry about pop teardrums anymore. I just got a new graphics card, yo man. How much did you pay for that, Master Shake? MSRP? Hopefully you didn't pay any of the overpriced stuffs, man. This stuff is scary. How high the pricing point for a lot of video cards are. Assassin's Creed, and when I open up the case, it looks like he never cleaned it out. Dust bunnies anywhere. Oh god. How old's your kid? This is a good time to teach him how to maintain a PC. Right while the lesson is fresh in his mind. So you have to clean your PC twice a year. And what you have to do is this, open it up. If you don't open it up and do it, you're going to burn another graphics card. Then you should be like, I could buy another one for you. But if you don't learn how to do this and you burn another one, that's it. It's a great time for a lesson. Great time for him to learn. My wife bought it for me for my birthday. Hey, that's nice. Good stuff, Master Shake. What'd you get? What kind of GPU did you get, man? That's always cool, man. The wifey knows. You got a 3080? Yo, damn. That's like $2,000, dude. Holy crap. Got a 3080, dude? That's impressive. I hope your wife got you a new one and not refurbished or anything like that. Because there's so many mined out 3080s out there. It's a little bit worrying. You never want to have anything that's been used, right? I'm a trophy husband? Oh, damn. Master Shake, man. You must be good looking. Do you look like Captain America, dude? Chris Evans? I feel like that's got to be a requirement, man. You gotta look like Captain America. You gotta be buff like him too. You gotta say stupid shit like, I could go all day. I don't know, man. Trophy husband. That's a dream, dude. If I could be a trophy husband, I would. I would love to be a trophy husband. Stay at home, stream, clean the house, cook. I'm an Iron Chef, baby. Cooking is easy. But making money, though, that's a tough time. I should actually move the Pokeshell, huh? Oh, let's just put a second. Yeah. Just put a separate room. Actually, no, it's probably fine. So, we should just wrangle this guy. And then remove the doors from here. She makes the money, I make the dinner. Works for me. That's a nice time, man. That's a nice time. I wish I could do that. I gotta find someone to make the money so that I could do the cooking. Okay, so if I go here, I get a flyover so that I could see the surface of the map. That's actually pretty beneficial. So I'll go for that. And then this one is not maxed out. So we will do 5 here. Do a reset. This is a crew and we're going to launch. Any secrets on finding the on becoming a trophy husband man? Anything I should learn how to do? Do I need to be mad buff? What if I got dealt a bad hand and God was like, "You can't be good looking, son." What if it be like that sometimes? Does that mean all hope is lost, man? I gotta mop it up, clean that up. Not too bad. We got that mined out, so we can mine that out. Oh, he's yodeling. Nice. Wow, that was fast. I see you over there, Cthulhu. I see you over there. Single moms are a good start. I see you over there, Master Shake, man. I see you over there. So you're telling me I gotta go to the library? Alright. Grocery store? Wait, what if I become a bag boy then? Hey miss, you need some help carrying those groceries? Start flexing. I'd be mad funny, man. Hey miss, you need help with those groceries? Start flexing like it's freaking, you're at a strongman competition. Does that actually work? It doesn't, right? That's gotta be 100% meme. Target's the spot. You know what, dude? Is it me or is Target mad expensive? Like everything there at Target just seems way more expensive than it should be. Am I alone in that thought process? Like, Target feels like it's mad expensive, man. That does not work. Alright, man. Feels bad. The dream is dead. Like, compared to Walmart? I mean, for whatever reason, man. Everything is expensive right now. Yeah. I mean, I get that, but it's like, it feels like Target has always been more expensive than everything else around it. Don't know if you guys feel the same way about it, but to me, that's what it feels like. West Coast problems, yo, feels bad. I read something on Reddit the other day that says, if you do grocery shopping at Target, you are a bad cook. And I was like, is that a wild take or is that actually justified? And then I was reading the comments and they were talking about how, yeah, Target doesn't actually have any groceries there. Everything there is pre-packaged. And I was like, oh shit, that actually makes sense then. It's like, yeah, if everything there is pre-packaged, are you really cooking good food? Gotta buy bulk from Costco? Dude, Costco is amazing, man. I read the thing where they're like, hey, everyone is, you know, raising their prices. You guys gonna change the price of the hot dog? No. Dude, Costco are legends, dude. Never gonna change the price of the hot dog combo. You gotta love that, man. Gotta love that about Costco. Sam's Clubs in Oklahoma. Sam's Clubs is literally just Walmart, though. But Costco bulk size. Walmart's cool though. I mean, Sam's Club is alright. I'm more of a fan of Costco for some reason. Also, another thing Costco does that's really pog, they hire internally. So if someone leaves the company, they will hire someone from within instead of hiring from outside. Oh, they have a food court at Sam's Club too? I've never been to Sam's Clubs, man. Not gonna lie. I've never been to one because I don't have a Walmart or Sam's Club in my area. Credible meats and produce at Sam's Clubs around here? I believe it. I believe it. Granted, the last time I checked, Sam's Club was a dollar cheaper. Oh, they got the price point, huh? Buy all my clothes there too. That's fine. That's fine. Nothing wrong with that. I've got both right next to each other, but over the years, we preferred Costco nearly always. Ah, interesting. T-shirts in bulk is awesome. Dude, gotta get the jeans there, man. Gotta get some of the sweaters. Gotta get, like, the boxers and socks from Costco. Only way to do it. Do they have free samples? I mean, with COVID going on? I would imagine no, but do they do free samples at Sam's Club? Because that's the reason why, as a kid, I loved Costco. All the free samples, man. You would go there and be like, oh, what's this? Oh, that's delicious. You guys know what I'm talking about, man? The free samples were the bomb, man. It was enough of a reason to go to Costco. Oh, you do? Okay. That's nice. That's actually pretty cool, then. Swedish meatballs? Oh, man. Every time I hear the word Swedish meatballs, I can't help but think about horse meat. Does anyone relate, man? Is it weird? That it feels that way for me, man? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I would go straight here. Actually, I would want to go to here to get to that tile, but since we know there's no question marks, I think I do go straight. Yeah. So crew, that's a good spot. Max travel distance, and we'll be ready to launch. You might have just ruined Swedish meatballs for me. No. There was, someone said that historically Swedish meatballs were made from horse meat. And it was because in Sweden, they didn't have much livestock to choose from. But it shouldn't be. It should not be. Or am I thinking of something else? Are Swedish meatballs even from Sweden? Wasn't that a viral thing too, where they were talking about that? These were made in the U.S. But inspired by the Swedish sauce. Oh! What's in the Swedish sauce? What makes the sauce Swedish? You didn't buy any, though? Yo, man. I've had Swedish meatballs from IKEA. That's fine. Even though I had the idea of the horse meat in my mind, I was like, whatever. Gotta eat it, man. It is what it is. Dude, have any of you guys gone to IKEA recently, man? The IKEA kind of close by, not really, I have to drive kind of far. They are stepping up their food court game, man. I thought that was kind of weird. But IKEA is stepping up the food court game. They used to have like only like, oh, pizza, hot dog, Swedish meatballs, right? Soda, coffee. And then a lot of the snacks and candies. Now, the last time I went, they have a full-on cafeteria. You get to choose whatever you want. Spaghetti, meatballs. You get the salads there now. They're stepping it up, man. Alright, so we've been releasing a lot of oxygen. How bad is this? Oh, dude, we are stockpiled with oxygen still. I could just let this run forever. Yeah, until the top one cools down a little bit. Oh my god. I'm running out of oxygen at the top. Are you serious? I actually can't believe it. We're actually running out of oxygen here. Ah, damn. So I have to actually have this, huh? Feels bad. So we'll do it like that for now. And then we will also have it be like this. And that's going to be actually fine. Oh, I can't believe this ran out of oxygen. We have to slowly wait for the deodorizers to get back on track. We have a lot of polluted oxygen. Have a lot of tons of polluted dirt. I think we just overconsumed, which is very likely. And I also released 210 kilograms of oxygen accidentally. Air quotes accidentally. Alright. Grab the water. Alright, so do we have enough steel to make the base of my great monument? Oh, we can. Let's go. Okay. I wanted it to be closer to this side, so we're gonna do these two. Have it over here. I think that should be fine. I am going to be moving over my ladder one or two tiles. At least one tile. So I think that's fine. So, furniture copy. And then four. And then four right there. So I guess I do want this going all the way up here. There we go. After we finish that, I don't have anything for the midsection. I have plastic, I have ceramic, it's the steel. I'm missing steel. Which means I don't have enough eggshells. Man. I'm out of lime. That's my bottleneck. That's actually my bottleneck right now. No lime, no fossil. Okay. There's no way to get me fossil from the bottom of here. It doesn't exist. I don't have fossil anywhere else. The only thing I could do, I guess, is to grow more critters so that we have a lot more eggs to be cracking. This is a 96 tile. Nice. I guess we should start moving the stone hatches into here. ...15, 19, that's fine. That should work. And then this is going to be 8. Stonehatch. Because I have sedimentary rock for these guys. Lower this to priority 8. Drop off should be a 9. Cool. So now all we have to do is wrangle. Regardless of age, we're just going to grab the stone hatches. And then this guy as well. Oh, we're there. Okay. We go to here, we see that one, and then we want to move over to this side. We could see the planet top now. Ah, look at that. Artifact. So this is where the tree is. usually the artifact is right next to the tree. That's pretty good. There's no open ceiling for puffs to fly out. No slime lung on the initial oxygen. Okay, that's not bad. I probably do want to build a rocket to stop by there. And I think we're going to have to do it on this rocket. Yeah, it's probably worthwhile to get the basic nose cone set up for this. Oh, we were supposed to... I'll actually do this now, before I even switch this. I guess this is a good spot, because we have room for it. But I guess we'll do it down here. So, rocket platform. We are going to build right here. And we're going to try to do databank research at the bottom. I'm pretty sure that if this does work, Clay is going to patch it. They will patch it. Because I believe this would not be something they would like to have feasible. If I am able to do the databank research at the bottom of the map. So we'll see if that's a thing. I have infinite clay, so I gotta keep making ceramic. And I do have a lot of sand. Oh, it's going down. I'm not gonna do any more then. Alright, so build the Spacefarer module. Do we not have... Oh, this is still here. The water's there. It's gonna leave once it's done. Alright, we gotta wait for that to actually get deconstructed. We got it, we got it. We can actually put more solar panels here now. Alright, so that's good. This should allow me to build my new rocket here. We'll make it out of copper, sure. And then I should be able to run on the ledge right there. That's actually no ladder required. So we gotta wait for it to be built. Alright, so interior. I'm outside. Light, radiation, sweet, sweet. Okay. So, rocketry. No, station. Orbital data collection lab. I don't have power. So I have to have someone run the hamster wheel in here. That's fine. So because of that, I have to release oxygen. And then also because of that, I need the manual gen. And then no battery module. We have to keep the power inside. We're going to have regular ladders. We'll do that so that we can build a plastic ceiling. So that I'm not worried about radiation. And then the battery. It doesn't matter which one I use. We have to move that to the right. Just for the Tetris. I wonder if this works, man. This would be very interesting if it does. Alright, wait and see. While we do that, let's actually redo this rocket. We'll make it into another... We'll make it into the colonizing rocket. I need to be able to set up rocket platforms, so I need to do this regardless. The battery's fine. Gotta get rid of the cargo bay. Basic nose cone. Solar panel module, sure. And then on top of that, I need a steel rover setup. And then a steel trailblazer module, which should be a swap from this. Nice, perfect size. That's max height. Can't really do more than that. Can't grab artifacts. So I guess it's time to do this. So it's probably going to be the same setup. Here, here. Have the wall toilet. Piping. Have that decon, nice. Plastic tiles. That goes there. Furniture. It's gonna be two dupes. Oops. Autosave lag. There we go. That's gonna be a room. That's gonna be a room. I need a ladder for that to work. Technically, I don't need the telescope here. So what else would I have? If I don't have a telescope... Oh... I would need a suit dock. Because I would want to change suits. Well, if I'm just colonizing, I wouldn't need that. I guess we could just put the telescope on here, just in case we land on a planet that allows us to scan. I think that's kind of a waste of time, though. So, if I don't do that, I could technically move my beds up. Okay, let me decon this. Let me ladder up here. Put the door at the bottom. And then do 12 tiles there. We could put two regular beds. And then this is going to be our meal hall. And then we could have suit docks right here. So I won't build that yet. I'll just build the checkpoints. And then we have the rocket module inside the bathroom. And for the time being, we'll put the oxygen or canister emptier. Kind of like that. Actually, wouldn't I have it based off of the oxygen vent? That's probably what I would have, right? That makes a lot of sense. I wouldn't need that. That's going to be my power outlet to the battery module. Alright, so that should be fine. Nutrient bars, I'll take that. Alright, alright. Let's make this a higher priority. How are my rockets? It's there, nice. Oh, dude, what is this? Dude, that looks crazy. We're going to that. This is glimmering tungsten. Oh, wow. Dude, I'm getting all the rare asteroids. I'm not even kidding. I'm actually getting a lot of the rare asteroids. So we're going to be going to here. Since that's no question marks like that, I don't have to explore it. That's going to be a point of interest. This is probably... I don't know. I want to say that's a point of interest as well. And then I do think that's potentially the temporal tear. The one on the edge of the map right there. I'm going to want to check that out so I could beat the game. And then... we could build a great monument. Opening, breaching, establish several colonies. We could do that pretty soon. Oh! I didn't activate this. Oh, come on. Zero IQ plays by me. We'll probably want to go back though. Check out the forest at the bottom. And then we do have this planet that didn't seem to have artifacts in general, unless it's on the left side. There is a room right here. I'll probably want to stop by and then build the printing pod on top to establish the colony. So those two wouldn't be too bad. So that'd be one, two. I have to go to here probably, get the artifacts. That's three. I don't want to do that because it's a pain. I do have to go to the ice, so that's four. This also has... I'll probably go to this one. It's not too bad, but there is meteorites from the gassy moos. it's kind of a pain. But we should be good. Alright, Orion, so far so good. Everything seems to be... rolling. I need to be able to drop off brine somewhere. I'll do that on the side again. And then... map is pretty good. I should try to clean that out. A little bit of gas there, but it's nothing to worry about. CO2 chlorine. Polluted oxygen. If I want to clean it up, I should try to just pump out the polluted oxygen. I feel like that makes a lot of sense. I don't want to deal with the different elements floating around, so pumping that up should be okay. Alright, I'll crack this open next time. I don't want to release the thermal energy yet. Radiation. Cool, cool. So if we're done... Oh, this is done. Oh, the rocket is grounded. Yeah, so even though it shows radiation and sunlight here, it doesn't count. It's still considered grounded. Yeah, all right. So we can't... We got a mutant seed? From the shine bug? Are you serious? 50 rads per cycle. I rolled a 1%. That's literally like a 1%. That's the lowest form of radiation you could have. And I got a mutated seed. Dude, always lucky, man. I'm probably not going to use it, though. Okay, so we found this out. It doesn't do anything. It seems like it's grounded. Seems like we can't do anything about that. Now... I got an idea, though. Can I cheese that still? Let me deconstruct this. Everything inside just kind of falls to the ground, so I'm not worried about that. Can I do that here? I'll have to wait till I deconstruct that one, though, before I can build a new one. Because technically, I'm in space. Would the game get tricked that if I have it floating in the space vacuum, that I could do the research without lifting off? Yeah, so that's gone. Let's check it out. Oh, it's blocked because of the ladder. Alright, that's cooled down. I can shut this off. Alright. Alright. So we'll do that, and then deconstruct the rocket platform. See if that affects anything. Otherwise, we're doing pretty good. We need to find the temporal tear location. Everything there is empty. Okay. So I do want to get that to see the corner. And then I want to get these two. Still moving. Nothing along the edge, though. That's actually really good for me. Finding what's in the question mark spots, a little bit tedious sometimes. And it's always lime. Okay. Great monument, shouldn't take too long. Establish several colonies. And then the artifacts. The terrestrial ones. We have one already. Right there. You know what? I want to see... Now, this is just a neurovacillator, right? There's some sleet wheat grain there. That's nice. I don't think they're holding an artifact here. And that's going to be the only one on the planet. So we start off with one. We see one here, too. There's nothing on this one. This one probably... I gotta send a rover there or something. I think that's what I'm gonna want to do. Can I swap the rover? Oh, I can't swap it to a different element. Okay, I just gotta remove it then. Your new stable doesn't have food set. Oh, crap. It was supposed to be on sedimentary rock. Did I change that on my other ones? No. Okay, that's weird. Good eye, Mind Fury. Appreciate that, man. sedimentary rock. All right, the sages are chilling. 8 critters, 5 out of 8. Okay, so we will just do a... how do I want to do this? It's just a bunch of hatches. I might just want to randomly just move them myself. And we'll move them to this one. Just by hitting auto wrangle. Good eye, though. Good eye. And copy, paste. So I want the coal, though, because eventually we're going to have to use coal for the radiation setup. For the breaching of the tear. We're going to have to charge the tear opener. So it's going to be something I'm going to want to have. Okay, so here, here, here. I don't want to waste steel. So we're going to use aluminum. With the aluminum rover, we could drop it off. And we don't even need a full rocket engine. Should be fine. I need to check out that left side, man, to see if there's a artifact waiting for us. Alright. Another thing I think I should make, just cuz, is going to be the clothing refashionator. And I'm just going to want to upgrade some of my snazzies so that every dupe has nice clothing. Why not, right? Got to give the dupes what they want. Okay, so this is ready. Let's remove that. Let's remove this. Yo. With the quickness. Okay, that's gone, that's gone. Station, data lab. Let's see what happens when we build one of these. Because technically we're in space. Radiation, right? If it still says it's grounded, though, it's probably not going to be able to work. Which is fine. Have to try out the ideas, though. In case that's a new way to be able to do data bank collection without lifting off. Pretty convenient. But it's not necessary to be able to do. 75 kilograms. It's catching up. This is at 700. Jeez. Alright, so this is going to be sweep only brine so that we can remove the bottle. New printables. Take the copper ore. And it's not ready. Can they make the jump? I might need the ladder. We got this guy to deal with. Easy does it. I hear you, Mamba. I hear you. Alright, we got that done, so this, that's gonna be what I want to mine out. Hopefully they don't climb up to mine this dude, and then they're gonna jump up and get stuck. Feels bad, taking forever to build that. The cooling right here is evened out. I can't mop that out until I build some extra tiles. Not bad, though. It's not bad. I hear you, babies. You're gonna be okay. How are my rockets? This one is there. We grab the artifact. Ooh, 2 spots. So, 1, 2, 3. So I should be here. Whoa, 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 whoa. Here to here is 7. 8, 9. Hold up. Hold up, hold up. I have 10 tiles remaining. I actually can't do that. Oh, good thing I checked. So we're going to here first, so that we could see what's on this tile. and then I will have 9 tiles remaining, and then going back is going to be 8 tiles. And then if I go over here, I'll be at 8 tiles, but then that's going to be a 9 tile travel. Oh, that sucks. Maybe we go, nah, I want to check what that is, to be honest. And then this one is good. I need to go here. This is 13 tiles. So here to here is 7. Going up is slightly not bad. And I get these 3 question marks. Yeah, we're going to go that way. Cool, cool. I almost debated my own dupes, dude. I'm happy that I did it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We should be fine. We should be fine. Alright, alright. So, I need to have lime. Does this have fossil? It does. I should go here just to grab the fossil, right? So, going to here, allow manual use. I don't have lime here, probably. Fossil falls under... oh, raw mineral, right? Nice. Alright, so we'll do that later. We'll have to start setting up some mining paths without breaking into the spore grid. Yep. And... is this charged up? It is. Guess who's coming, boys? The man of the hour. His name is Cthulhu. We're sending them back to the gulag. This is taking forever. There we go. Alright, so we're back. We need to go jump here. Jump here. And then I could do both sides. Yeah, 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 yeah. More intermittent fasting. At least he knows. He knows now. I'm happy that you're starting to understand, Cthulhu. He's learning, boys. He knows when he's starting to fast. This side. This goes down here, and then I go up this way, that way. We grab those two. No zombie spores. That's good, that's good. Eventually, I want to get to here and here. And here. And I guess right there. So the thing afterwards is running for power. And we're also going to cut that so the pump doesn't turn on. Cool, cool. Just gotta fill it up with fossil and we'll be good. We'll check back on Cthulhu in a little bit. He's got some jobs to do. 2 seconds. Now we wait here. Here to here is 8 out of 9. Yeah, I don't wanna push it. Forever fasting. It's good for your health. So guys, does anyone know how fasting benefits you? Does anyone know how that's beneficial to the body? I have never really understand how fasting works. Let's get one of these spiffy overalls. And then I think we'll take 1 pom-pom. I have a purple polyester. I don't know if I have a pink unitard, though. I'll make 1 of each. I have a confetti suit. I saw someone wearing it. We got some blue suits as well. Alright, alright. We are pretty much sitting pretty. Doing a lot of excessive things that otherwise we wouldn't have to do, to be honest. and we're not having a bad time. Everything is working pretty well. I would say that maybe it's working too well. That's potentially a thing. All right, so rocket pilot. We are gonna send Slayer by himself. He's gonna do a flyby to this planet and he'll come back. This is rovers inside. Oh, it's waiting aluminum. I gotta wait for this. Once we get that, we'll be ready. I do need to get another rover though, because I want to search that planet for an artifact. Hopefully we have it there. Look at this guy catching his breath. Oh, nice. Cthulhu got some fossil coming back. Nice. Let's go, let's go. I'm able to get lime now. Dude, look at that. Oh, I'm only getting 100 kilograms of 200 kilograms. I can make two? What a travesty. What a travesty. All right, it's up to four. So it drops off that's the loader. Oh, it's right there. Okay. We have a lot of fossil for him to pick up, so it should be fine. Just a matter of time for him to deliver everything at this point. I could have him mine more so that I could send someone else later to start storing everything. I don't think it matters too much, though. I also probably want to send back some diamonds. Sometimes at the bottom of the forest, they have a room, a gravitas room, and I'm thinking that's where the artifact's going to be. Who knows though, right? Who really knows? This is... we got the rover, nice. Warnings, proceed with launch. We're waiting for crew. Lander is ready. Wait a second. I could just re-land. I don't think I finished the inside of that rocket. That's what I'm thinking right now. Oh, there's no oxygen in here. However amount of oxygen he has, it's how much he's gonna have. That's totally not scary. Yeah, that's totally not scary. We're just going to deploy a rover. How long it's going to take? Half a cycle. Oh, no. Oxygen was forgotten, dude. Huge rip. The only thing I could do is hope someone... I hope he pees his pants. So we could add some polluted oxygen in here. But we got the wall toilet stuff. Feels bad, then. So I kind of want to watch over this guy so that he doesn't stay out here excessively. Ooh, radioactive asteroid. Cool, cool. Have this come back home. You're idle? Why are you idle? Why aren't you always driving? That's the one thing I'm worried about. Can you disable the toilet? I don't want to force him to poop his pants, though. That is probably something I could do. Oh, I could. Voting disable. Is he allowed to pilot Slayer? He is. Why doesn't he like the pilot? Is it because he's hungry? Is it a schedule thing? No, he should be working. I guess he's just slacking off. I think it'll be fine. It'll be fine. So we clean this up. Clean that up. Oh, did this ever get built? Grounded surface of a planetoid. Yeah, you have to be launched. Okay. At least I figured that out now. Slayer and Cthulhu was not permitted food. Come on, Cthulhu. You got this. Oh, I gotta activate this as well. Starvation Cthulhu. Aw, come on, dude. He's always pooping and starving. Take the Joya Seeds. Can you activate? Activate. Thank you, thank you. Come on, you gotta catch your breath. 900 calories. Cool, cool. What? What? Cthulhu, what are you doing? He's on sleep. Ah, oh, you're actually gonna starve, man. You're gonna die, dude. Just saying. Hear me out. What if he gave you some food? Food's back at home, dude. We have food at home. What are you talking about? You know that meme? Can we get some ice cream? We have ice cream at home. This is active. Nice. And let's go. Dude, go home, man. Go home. Come on. Hey, you're gonna be fine. This is active now. Nice, nice. Go eat, buddy. Deserved it. And I'm there. I need to deploy the rover. I will land on the left side this time. And let me look at the planet. It's there. Star map. I'm going back home. 1.4 cycles. Oh, I hope that's not the case. He's gonna suffocate. That's not a good look. Alright, so I need to do this. Alright, that's gonna allow me to build a door. Thanks for the stream, too legit. Thank you for being here, Suki. I'll take the face cam stream thing. I'll think about it. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see what we have in the future. But thank you for being here. Hope you have a good night, and we'll see you next time. Oh, it begins. Oh, it begins. No! He's starting to suffocate? Okay. What can I do? How long is this? Half a cycle, dude. This goes down 1% a second. So I have 30 seconds, 40 seconds. So, can you drive, man? That would be amazing. I don't want Slayer to die though, man. So we do have the abandoned rocket ship button. But if I'm on this tile, I go home. And then I don't want to break my Radbolt rocket. That's the thing. That's a lot of steel, man. Damn it, man. Am I going to lose another one? I could abandon ship. But it's going to fly towards this planet. Which means that although, you know, this is cool, I guess I could have him, like, explore with this dude. You knew there was no air and sent it anyway. You know what we should have did? No! I got the strats. I got the strats. I can't do this? I can't Trailblazer right now. I could actually land. Oh, dude, that, yeah, I could land here. Get some oxygen, put some polluted water inside, and I'm good. I'm actually good if I do that. Okay. So let's go back. How much oxygen does he have? 11%. Can I change and land there immediately? Oh, wait. Do I have enough time to run out into the oxygen? There is nowhere you sent it anyway. Do you have a soiled suit? They do not. There's a bathroom inside, sadly. All right, so it's already landing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, and he's dead. No, we were right there. Should we save Slayer? Slayer, are you here, buddy? Slayer, you here, buddy, man? I forgot to put oxygen on the rocket and we sent it anyway. You kind of suffocated, man. I hate to say this. But, should I reload the save? Or I think we have to take the L, man. Ah, that's gross. If I did that earlier, when he had 30% oxygen, we would have been fine. I just made a bad decision. I was hoping that we could cross. It was planned. I'm not a murderer. All right, we'll save. We'll save. We'll save Slayer, dude. It was not. I'm not a murderer. I did not plan for this to happen. Sometimes, man, he just has it in the dice. They don't think it be like it is, but it do. Alright, so this autosave, is this after I launch or before? Oh, this is the rover. Oh yeah, yeah, we just landed. Okay, so I actually just go here. There we go. Watch Cthulhu die, because we didn't send him back. No, it's charging already. Cool. We're back to here. It was too legit in the rocket with the vacuum. Yo, man. We got this time, no worries. I can't. Oh, crap. I have to wait for my rover. Wait a second. Mafic and Mafic. So we do that, and then I need to make Mafic ladders. And I should be able to climb down. What? I could just climb down? There's a step on the engine? What is going on? Alright, we gotta drop off some polluted water. Y'all know what it is. Dude, they just climb up without the ladder. That's impressive. Alright, so the closest open tank is probably here. Nah, it's probably this one. Alright, so the rover needs to continue. We go down to here, we go there. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Jump, jump. And then from there, I probably want to go inside to the left. So I should do something like that. All right, now from here, maybe I run across to this side. And then by running across, we could just build a pitcher pump here. Oh, we have goldfish purifying this, huh? I think I need to do this. And I should be able to do that. Is there a bunch of pea dirt you could grab? I'm trying to spill water on the ground. The polluted water. I see you over there, the imposter. It's a good idea. Got a cobalt volcano. Oh, there's nothing here. Oh, that means it's no artifacts. Alright, let me mine this. And put a pitcher pump right here. And then we'll be able to just pump water out. And that means there's really no artifact. Okay, so we'll do that. And then we'll see what we have. That should reveal the entire map except for this corner. I can't imagine there's an artifact in the corner. So there's really just nothing to take home. So that's ready. We're just going to drop pea water on the ground. Grabbing some pea dirt wouldn't be a bad idea. We'll have a bin right here for that. Yeah, there's nothing here, dude. Crap. So this is not a good thing for me because that might mean that I'm getting a low roll on terrestrial artifacts. Which might mean that I have to actually go to the gassy or to the regolith asteroid. Which I don't want to do. I really don't. If I can avoid it, I kind of want to avoid it. So let's mine some polluted dirt. We should have a lot of it. And then get that to off gas. I heard the sound of someone being trapped. So I'm paused. Organic pea dirt. And then, oh, he's trapped here. That's not real. Okay. 8 out of 16. This is fine to get removed now. Is the rockets coming back? This one is chilling. This one has 10 tiles to travel. Eight tiles, not bad. Why does it keep saying trapped, dude? It's so weird. That sucks. That rover, we just realized that, you know, got no real options inside. So I think once we get... There we go. Once we get 100 grams of oxygen in here, we're set. That's all we're needing. 100 grams. Right now we're at 1 gram. We'll get there. We do have pea water we could auto bottle. Outside of that, there's not really much we could... Oh, I need to grab a thimbleweed. So I need to mine that. None of that is thimbleweed. Over here is a seed. Two right there. We're going to go try to grab it. Because that's going to be how I get cuddle pips. And who doesn't want cuddle pips? So once we get enough oxygen in here, we're going to want... We'll just drop the water off and then I'll grab thimbleweed seeds from this. Ah, yes. Should be good. Oh, he's... Oh, no. He's starting to be hungry? Oh, this is a trap. Oh my god. I didn't know that's why they couldn't grab the water. Oh my god. Okay, so we gotta do swamp chard for him. Alright, we'll do that. We will allow Slayer to eat some swamp chard. And with that, he should be able to eat. And then we could grab the Reed Viper before leaving. Grams, dude. We're getting there. It's gonna take a long time. Holy crap. Starvation! So he should be able to climb up this way now, right? So we're not gonna allow you to go down this door anymore. You gotta go all the way around the other side. You could breathe now. You could start eating the swamp chard. Eat that, man. Swamp chard heart. Nice. So how... Oh, you can't go inside. Oh, that sucks. I was going to say, why is Rover not actually pumping up the water and dropping it off like he should? He's actually just, you know, can't go inside the rocket. Forget about that sometimes. Alright, one... He can't sleep. We just need one auto drop of water, man. That's all we need. I wonder how long it's going to take him to be able to leave that actual asteroid. Exhausted. Dude, he's also low morale right now. Everything about him is low. Calories. I look like I should be grabbing more swamp chard heart, to be honest. Looks like I should try to grab as much as I can. Because he's gonna need the food. Get the pea water. Nice. He's gonna drop it and go back. Oh god. Is he gonna pick up the bottle again? Because if he doesn't, I think we make it. Oh, he does another one. Oh, no stamina. Oh, God. The death loop begins. Slowly gonna whittle away. Thimbleweed seed. Oh, that's a bad thing to grab. At least it's gonna be close by now. Drops it here. There we go. It's gonna go back for oxygen. And that should fix it. He's going to be able to leave but not go back in. So he's going to be forced to go inside whatever he has. A bottle of pea water. Oh, now he's hungry. Ah, God. At least Slayer's not dead. At least Slayer's not dead. There we go. So, no stamina. He's trying to get into bed. Oh, that's a bad play. Because he's not going to be able to breathe. Oh, there's an angle here. Whatevers. Let me put a second door right there. Actually, it doesn't matter. I think I want a tile here then. F- 15 grams. I just need one water bottle drop and I should be fine. And I might as well make a mini pod here. Since up here. Oh, he's unable to... Oh, I didn't even notice that. Alright, we gotta build this to set him up. Alright, so now... You are relieving self. This is gross. Can't even use the bathroom inside. Now, the good news is that they could release the polluted water underground for some more oxygen. We're leaving self again. You're not going to make it. The dance of death. Running in and out constantly. Now I'm worried about taking out the suit, because taking out the suit's probably not a good thing. Due to how, if the suit's worn out, I won't be able to put it back on. Now she's starving. I need her to pee her pants. That's exactly what I need to do. After she pees her pants, bladder goes down, she could eat, and then I could lock the door so that we get the first bottle of water. We'll reject all. I don't need the oil anymore. Dude, why is she just... Just pee your pants, man. What are you doing? Yeah, she was just sitting in the radiation for the longest. Alright, she gets to eat. This forces her to stay here. Get as much of the food as she can. I need the bladder to actually reset. Come on. There we go. Alright, so now we could leave one way. Oh, sleeping. Just sleep here, man. Holy crap. Stamina is an issue now. Alright, once the next stamina thing happens, hopefully we'll grab water and leave. Oh, there it is. Polluted water. Stop scratching yourself. All right. We could force it so that she can't go outside anymore and has to go in all the way. The scratching animation is ruining it for me, though. All right. That pushes that up. We probably have her be able to go back inside for another breath. All the off-gassing. I'm able to breathe inside. Oh, it's time. Thug life. I'm going home. It's time to leave, fam. We'll probably stop by here another time. But we saved Slayer. Oh my god, this was so painstakingly tedious. As long as we're able to breathe inside the rocket module, we're going to be fine. Yep, we're fine.
Oh my god. What a struggle, man.
Just to prevent this guy from dying. I can't believe it. We actually made it back. Alright, so that should take no longer than like a cycle, two cycles. Not bad, not bad.
Alright.
And I think with that, it's gonna be time to wrap things up, you guys. Sorry for the super tedious ending. But, you know, when it comes down to something like that, there's nothing you could do. Unless you're more prepared. In which case, I was not prepared.